Hi, my name is Ben Brownlee for Boris Effects, and in this quick tutorial, we're going to be breathing new life into old particle illusion presets using new generative AI. Okay, and here is our original shot. We've just got a quick push in on a coffee cup. Very nice. And I'm going to add a little bit of steam to this. And this is a perfect job for particle illusion. So I come up, I go to particles and particle illusion. And let's launch the particle illusion interface. And you'll see over on the left-hand side that we have a lot of lovely looking presets that we can start to work with. So I'm going to come down into my smoke category and see if there's something here that's going to be suitable for us. Actually, maybe vapors or vapors too. No, we'll stick with classic vapors. And I'll just double click to load this into the stage. And let's close up the presets so we have a little bit more space dedicated to our actual interface. And we'll take a look at the vapors emitter that has been applied to the stage. And see it's a line emitter, so I'll place it generally where I want it to be and maybe just take these off. Now, if you don't like this overlay that's happening when we're near a point, that's easy to turn off in the preferences. So I go to my preferences and I can turn off show stage tool tips. So now we can just see our points in peace. There we go. All right, so let's play this back and it's looking all right, but we can do more with this. Now, commonly, when you apply a preset, you're going to make a few changes to the parameters just to make sure that it fits into your project. And this vapors is no different. So we could come in and use zoom. Zoom is usually the primary way of making something bigger and kind of fill more of the screen. I think that's done something there for us. We can just come straight into size, and that's just going to change the size of the particles. I'll undo that. I'll also take the strength down, or the opacity down, on the overall emitter because we want to be able to see through a lot of this steam. And we end up with something like that. It's not a bad start. Let's add a force in, because a force is going to be something to help to give this a little bit more realism, a little bit more life. So let's come in. I'm just going to move my force around. So it's got a force box. Let's make this a little bit bigger. And I'm going to adjust one parameter in this force to make everything change. And that is enable fluid dynamics. And as soon as I turn this on, we'll see that the motion that's happening within this force is very different to what was going on previously. So instead of going up, we've now got fluid dynamics coming in to help to swirl this around a little bit. I'll make a slight adjustment to the direction. Let's have this pointing up. There we go. And we've got some wispy stuff happening now. I might add a little bit of noise to this. So I'll go with the noise amount, just turn that up just a little bit, maybe to 10. And my swirl amount, swirl turbulence, I'll just add a little bit to that as well. So we get a little bit of randomness. So this is starting to look a little bit more like steam, but I think we can do a lot more with one other change. And that's to change the sprite that is creating this steam. Because particle illusion isn't just throwing around little dots. In fact, all of our particles are based on sprites. So the choice of sprite can make a huge difference to the look of the overall emitter. Let me just duplicate this so we have a before and after to show you. And I'll just disable the top one. Here we go. So everything else is the same here. And I'm just going to double click on my particle sprite. And this brings us up into the sprite library, particle shape library. And you can see we have a lot of shapes that ship directly with particle illusion and the presets. Now, something that's new though is the ability to generate up new sprites directly within particle illusion. So I'm going to hit generate here, and you'll see we come into our generate particle shape window. Now, this is generative AI powered by Stability.AI. So let's load up a preset first. And we have presets for particle generation as well, so we're not kind of just starting out from scratch. Let's go with the top one, Steam Wisps. The advantages we have of being able to generate up sprites directly within Particle Illusion are many. But probably the biggest one for me is when we're doing this, we're basing our image off of the seed image. And this could either be like something we've loaded in here. If I just close it up in here, I'll come to smoke. I could happily just find another image in our library, go to generate, and that will become our seed image there. And the seed image can have a bigger part to play than typing in a hugely complicated prompt here. In fact, the prompt itself, I'm just going to keep what we had down at the bottom. So Steam Wisp, photorealistic, monochrome, black. And I'm going to hit generate. And it's going to generate up some images for me. Now, we're using the Stability.AI service to do this, which costs you credits. So each of these images costs a little bit of money, and depending on your settings, I think each image is about 0.2 cents. So they're very cheap to process. After a few moments, we now have our different smoke elements. Now, our image strength at the moment is set to 0.08, which is rather low. So it's using a little bit of the image strength, but it's also weighting the prompt a little bit more. If I turn this all the way up, in fact, let's not turn this all the way up, let's turn this to about 0.35 and hit generate again. What we're going to get now is images that are more closely related to the seed image. And we can see that right here, we've got the same sort of shape as the seed image, just higher quality. And I quite like all of these, actually. So let's just import one of them. Let's import the first one, and it's going to bring up our import particle shape as if we had just imported this directly off of disk. So we have the choice here to scale this down, which is probably a good idea because you don't want hundreds or thousands of 1024 by 1024 shapes floating around. So I'll just keep this at the default levels and just hit apply. And now we have our generated shape popping up in here. So let's hit apply on this. So we now have a very different looking bit of steam. In fact, this is looking a lot thicker than it was previously. So I'm going to have to come in and maybe adjust things like the opacity. Let's take the opacity down quite low. Take it to around about 4 or 5 maybe. And we might even want to change up the size. I can change up the size either within the particle itself, or I'll go right back to the main emitter and just change it overall here. There we go, that's looking quite nice. Now, there's another thing that we can do as well. If I come back into this particle and just double click on it, come into my shape, I'm going to go back into generate. And we have a history, remember, of all of the things that we have created. So if I did want to see how one of these other ones looked, I can just come in here, select one of these, hit import, and then hit apply on that. And we can immediately see what that's going to look like when we are playing that back. Do I like this more or less? I don't know, it's slightly different. But let's double click on this. I'll show you one more thing. Because we are spending money on these, even if it's a very small amount of money, we are saving these to disk as well. So we can import these all in later if we change our mind. So I'm going to hit import here, and I'm going to navigate to my generated image library. On Windows, it is under your user in documents, Boris effects, PI, generated images, and we can see all of the images that I have generated up here. And if I go right the way down to the bottom, we can see my series of steam that I created right down here. So I click on one of these images of steam and I hit open. Because we generated these images all at the same time, it's going to import these in as a sequence. Now, of course, we could rename these so we're not taking all of these in, or we're only taking in the subset. But this is really nice for having a bit of variety within our particle shapes as well. So I'm just going to import that shape sequence, hit apply. We can see the shape sequence up here, hit apply again. Now, the only thing I need to do is, well, if we play this back, it's going to look a little bit sort of noisy. So the only thing I really need to do is come back into the particle up at the top here and make sure it's using just a single frame and a random start frame as well. So now we have four different shapes being emitted from our main emitter. So it's going to give us a little bit of variety here. In fact, we can use this same idea to create up some much more kind of interesting, maybe even glitchy emitters as well, which is what I've done with this thing that I've got on the screen at the moment. So let's see how this looks back in After Effects. I'll turn on a sunbeam, which I've generated up just with the Continuum stage light, and we'll give this a quick RAM preview. And we end up with some very nice steamy coffee. So this is just one idea of what we can do with updating particle shapes using the new generate functions within Particle Illusion. There are of course tons of things that you can do with updating either the preset emitters or maybe making something brand new on your own. My name is Ben Brownlee for Boris Effects, and I'll see you again soon. If you want to see more Particle Illusion tips and tricks, be sure to subscribe to the Boris Effects YouTube channel and consider hitting the thumbs up button as well. And if you want to give Particle Illusion a run for yourself, then head over and download a free trial version of Continuum from borisfx.com.